Okay, keine Willenjahr, David Halt over the Moilem for an exciting speaker. So let me introduce to you the one, the only, Mr. Ben Halpern.
Okay, Mr. Kim, turn off of the screen. Ich bin confident that everybody was here, Kim and Hart, my start of Zandi Zach, got a heim, mit a bruche, bruche, a pikabul, a maitle mala, madeira chateva, in zai leben, in zai business, and you're going to see awesome success for just showing up here today. So du am aase, mit a bitzko vurke, so you came and a couple same, in zai gebeten, zai darf um huben geholfen werden, mit a baby, and unfortunately, keiner zinische can't help him. He sat with them, zei doorgegangen met zijn, zei zelf had hij gezocht. Ik kan eigenlijk het helpen. Alle tieren zijn ziek gemaakt. There's nothing I could do whatsoever to be able to help you, unfortunately. Het zijn rozgeschikt. And they left on the way to the horse and buggy. Is er bisschen boeken zijn nog gelaufen. Het zei, een minuut, kim zirik aan. Het zei gezocht. The embassy is, ik kan eigenlijk het helpen. There's nothing whatsoever I could do to help you. Aber eine Sache kenne ich ja tun. Ich kenne weinen mit denen, zusammen. In der Dreifen haben sich weggesetzt. Der Mann, der Frau, der wird sich wirklich geweint. In Angeduschen später haben sie solche geweint, so mal Ben suchen. Ich meine, als man kann zustellen, die Masse, bei Schmitte steht, die Chisäume in meinem Neuchal, hallo in Israel, hat doch gut nicht angepflanzt, wie soll ich mir essen? Sogt die Beschefe, wie sie wissen, es begrüßt sie. Stellt sich die Kasche, Tomer, ich frage, Demmels kriege ich. Tommer, ich frage nicht, bei Kimmich nicht. Aber ich dachte, gewaltig abschad. Ich habe gefragt, zwei ehrliche in seinen Masken gewesen. Steigt nicht, chissoi mar, ma echoil, und ma oichal. Sie steigt, chissoi mri. Jeden nehmen sich zusammen, and everybody says, not, I'm going to network, I'm going to come to event, ich rede mit anderen Menschen. Chissoi mri, ma oichal, wo ist geinz alle tien? Ins darfen doch alle helfen. In some Yiddish mishpuchas, whatever we make, we have to do so much more to be able to do for ourselves and help in Yana. Ma noichal, wuz gai mit alle teen zusammen. Oy bazoi zog de bashefer, betzivisias bechusi. So the fact that we come to such an event, and we're together, ma noichal, everybody's here to help everybody else, shoin is mezoichus de bruche betzivisias bechusi. So that's given. Aber, einsach verstein bei Yidin, dafür machen a keile. Kedai, de bruche gaat er ook komen met unkashale, in some getin inzis, du have a tzivisias bechusi. We need a kaila. How do we do it? So we're going to talk about now, Baruch Hashem, you heard a lot of kailam today. We gaat endigen met a praktische zaak. Wie azoi me ken hub matzloche on a sustainable way. Jeder ein in der room hat experienced dat zloche in leben. A get a choydish, a get a business deal, a run. But lamas at the end of the day, then it goes back down. We find mitzluchem success. Tamaris atamut chucham. On a regular basis, a kanak, business lot. They have success sustainable. Sagai, you lot. How do we have sustainable? What's the secret of sustainable success? Not successless man. We all have that already. We all have that in our life. But how do we have sustainable success? So it's based upon science and research, having interviewed, not me, people before me, hundreds of successful people who had sustainable success also given wusam zaigatim wusam gwein zaig trick wusam zaig lob zum success of an amal oif so man nehmt ach mit success and we make it be sustainable so you can have it oidach yom eshnois chaim clicker is not working in the back clicker can I shirik in the page could you bring me a clicker that works? This clicker is not. Nog een gein schnell. It's a gringe, when I grab it a PowerPoint, everybody could see it, and I'm a voice. What? Oh. Geit nicht. Oh, very good. Schreier. Okay. Everyone in this room, everybody in this room has, number one, only 24 hours in the day. That means to say at the end of the day, you're working with the same chesroinus or limitations that everybody has in the whole world. So we're going to have to make it within them. So the people that are extremely successful don't have more allocation for time than you have. All they got 24 hours. Zeh hu zeh. So we all got that. Number two, we all have skills, abilities, and talents that other people in this world have utilized to be able to make a lot more money and to see more success than we have with our skills, ability, and talents. So that's not our problem. Also, do mention, some got pink lookins at the skills, pink lookins at abilities, pink lookins at the talents, and ungekim avata viets. So mechanics, this is ovdu. So the tzat hotman, and some the skills, ability, and talents. So masach mei ratzluch v'sin sab mietz. Ich seh es nicht. Number three, opportunities. We live in America, people exactly like you, from your kraz, with your skills, and your abilities, and your talents, we're all able to go ahead and make it happen in a groyser oifen. So it's a possible thing. There's so much opportunity out there. Chadu getroffen, die gelat with businesses. I thought I'm going to come here. Everybody's either in insurance or in title or mortgages. So many interesting different things. There's so much opportunity. Not that there's no opportunity in mortgages. And in title, there's still so much opportunity. Azoifen gelat machen geld. A million gelat kenne machen geld. Zaza groyser welt. Millions of deals get done. So there's opportunity out there. So you have your time, you have skills and abilities, you have opportunity, and finally, the emotion of confidence. There are things in life that you're confident about, that you feel safe and secure, more than just driving a car, in parenting, in doing different things, in askunas things that you do. You feel confident, you feel on your game, you feel you can make it happen. So you have the skill of confidence. All we have to do is learn how to move the skill of confidence to other areas of your life, the hustle shine. How do we move confidence to your business? How do we move confidence that you're going to see success and continued success and roll and succeed in your life in a very, very big way? So let's talk about Lamasa, how to make that happen. Okay, so the Gemur and Bruches, Dav Zayin Zog, Gedoyle Shemisha Yoysim Elamida. Segresse, Meshamez Anatam Chochem, then figuring it out on your own. In other words, in English, success leaves clues. If we study the successful people, we'll find out there's a system to it, okay? I can't see on this screen, so I'll have to look this way. People who produce outstanding results do specific things to get those results. The science. You plant an apple tree, you get apples. You plant an orange tree, you get oranges. There are things that we do in business and succeed that helps us be able to move forward in life. Go figure out somebody what they did, and then we could do the same thing to be able to make it happen. I have done that work for you. I've done the research, and I'm going to share it with you. And finally, if you sow the same seeds, you get the same results. Thank you. Okay, so tachlis. We're going to try to study and figure out what the big chevet have done to be able to achieve it. What's the definition of the word success? Anybody, what does success mean? $1 million. $100,000, $10 million, a house with 15 bedrooms, a house with 13 bedrooms. What's the definition of success? Interestingly enough, they interviewed thousands of successful people, and they all gave the same answer. They all said the definition for success is the same. And we heard it today in the Army lunch break, Bayinat Vurem, they pretty much all said the same thing. What's the definition of success? The definition of success, I tried my best, and I learned something. So if I tried something, and at the end of the day, I was successful. I know now what not to do. Okay? That's how they interpret success. That success breeds success. And therefore, they make it very easy to succeed. Okay? I can't read the quote, but it's a good quote. Because I can't see it here. But basically, the concept is that if you can't fail, if you learn something, then you're successful. I never lose. I either win or learn. Okay, that's the definition of success. Now, going with that theme, what would be the definition of failure? They all, pe'echad, thousands of successful people gave the same Torah to explain failure. I gave up. If you don't give up, you haven't failed. Because you didn't give up. You still could succeed. You learned loads of information from your mistakes. You still could go. Game's not over till you give up. So you can't fail if you don't quit. Now let's make it practical. So the definition of success is, I try my best, I learn something. Definition of failure is, I give up. Now how do we make this look in the real world? So this is the ultimate success formula that we're gonna work with. It's a very simple process. The process is very simple. You decide what you want. Sof ma'aseh machshava tchila. You take an action. You do something. And then you evaluate. If it worked, gevaldik. If it didn't work, you learn something, gevaldik. Change your approach and keep on taking actions, and you're guaranteed to have hatzlocha, and you continue moving forward. What's going to stop you? So let's look at a picture. This is what's called the success cycle process. Okay? This is how it works. Let's break it down. The first thing is sof ma'aseh machshava tchila. You have a thought. The machshava is, I want to do this, I want to succeed, I want to build my business, I want to fix my marriage, I want to build my business, I want to do sales, whatever it is. If you have a thought, and a good thought, and a positive thought, and you're driven, it's going to lead to an emotion. So what's your emotion going to be? You're going to be hopeful, you're going to feel excited, because you had a good thought. Now, if your emotion is excited, what are you going to do? You're going to take an action, because you're driven. It's the guy in the pistin lamasa, you make a commitment, you do something from the ultimate success formula, you take an action. Now, if you take an action, you're going to get a result. Something's going to happen. Okay? Now, here comes the key. If the result is geschmack and good, the business mechazik and the guy's vata, se mechazik de machshuva, ase gelungen. Se mechazik de machshuva, is mechazik man emotion afilameid. My emotion I do more action, I get a better result, and Sagat Vata reinforces my thought, and I got mala, 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 and therefore it's called the success cycle, because you keep on going down, only up, up, and up, and up. Sounds so simple. If that's the case, why don't we keep succeeding? So why would it ever stop? Why wouldn't the edel keep on going? Knowing the answer to this question is how to keep your edel going and having sustainable success. Hence the title, The Secret of Sustainable Success. There are five reasons why success doesn't hold, and the edel zerbrecht sich. I'm going to go through them quickly, and then I'm going to explain each one in a practical way, and we'll wrap up with something you could take home today and change your life forever. Financial life, if that's what we're going to apply it to. Okay, the first thing is having high or unrealistic expectations. That means you may have success, but the reason why you don't recognize you have success and you break the edel is because it's high or unrealistic, and being named feels the nish as a gekimen tzatzloch. Zweite Sache is, the day controls you, rather than you controlling your day. So if the day controls you, you could do great things, but you're not going to succeed, because in order for you to succeed, you need to control your day and do what you need to be able to have atzlocha. Number three, focusing on what you don't want. Many people are busy a whole day focusing on what they're frustrated about and worried about and what they don't want, and at the end of the day, that's where you go. I'll show you how that works. Number four, focusing on what you cannot control. You come into the office, there are so many things you cannot control. If you're busy focusing and trying to control what you cannot control, you're going to waste your day, waste your energy, and not come tatzlocha. And finally, tefasta mida b'lo tefasta, making two big commitments. So you make a big commitment, and you can't stick with it, and therefore you don't continue with the process of success. Okay? Let's get to it. Number one, having unrealistic expectations. What does it mean? So stua yisod, fedav desler, hota yisod, and basically, it's the concept of Sarif Nikidas Abkhira. Let's say this is a line in life that represents your lifeline from 1 to 120. The first dot represents a salesperson in his first year. Okay? The second dot represents earning $1 million. So we have a salesman the first year, and he doesn't earn $1 million. So we could come to three determinations based upon this fact. The salesman $1 million. Number one, the salesman's no good. That's why he didn't make $1 million. If he was good, he would have made $1 million. Number two, the company's no good. If the company was good, he would have made $1 million. Number three, the product's no good. The product doesn't sell. What's the MS? None of the above three. It's not in the Nekidas Abkhira from a first-year salesman to make $1 million. The dot is here. The dot for $1 million is further down the line. But if he will touch it up that he wasn't successful because he didn't make $1 million, it's over. He's not going to continue doing it because he was a failure, because he came in and he didn't make $1 million. So if our goal, if our expectation is so high and it's unrealistic, then of course he's not going to be matzliach. Even if he's matzliach, he's not matzliach. And then he stops doing it because he's it. I took an extreme mushul to make the point. But it doesn't matter. If you expect something and you touch up that not happening as you not having atzlucha, you're done. Because you broke the cycle. If you discount success, you basically break the cycle. You say, chanushkan atzlucha, why bother? Chanushkan energy is tinachamu. What's medav tzatin is to celebrate success. Afila tomich hamachep is always gelernt. Zigang atrop, tomich bitzefrieden, zigang 1% besser. Ich tiers water, it went 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, over 100% in 7 cycles. So you got to recognize and celebrate success. So how does it look in the cycle? It means the box of results. So afila tomich hagata gitte machshova, in the machshova zibi gangem, so I get to gefeel, and I'm confident, and I'm happy, and I think I'm going to do well. And then my emotion triggers an action. I do an action, but then it comes to the result, and it's like, nah, I didn't make $1 million. Nah, when the shun came in, it didn't work. He didn't pick up. It's not working out. It breaks. Cycle's over. Because you're not allowing it to go further. In order for the cycle to go further, the next arrow has to come in. You have to see the result. You either learn something. We talked about the definition of successes. I got a result. I learned something. Or I succeeded. But either way, I got a result. Remove the result, it's a dead cycle. It's done. It's a guy to shvata and soft mouth. And then all of a sudden, you got to start again. Machinishkakoich is the start every year. Mitzlach diga people, since their definition for success is I learned something, I try my best and I learn something, they always make the cycle go. So they find genug for frisch. The thought goes, the emotion goes, the action goes, the results goes. And it's a guy tibbet and never, never. The mushal that you should use to remember this problem is when a child starts to walk. Imagine you tell the kid, "No, why don't you grow up already? Nocha trepkele, nocha thing. Let's go, grow up already, make it happen. You're not going to get anywhere. You're going so slow." No, we do the opposite. Meklatch, the baby gets up, atrab, gemuf, we klatch. That's why we use the success cycle. You matzliach, you held up for an extra second, you made progress. What's the gatin? Stung gechapt off the couch. Yo, you chaptun on the couch, gewaldig. And we build them up, and that's how they go, and they walk. Everybody can learn to walk. Everybody learn to be succeed. But let's use the same thing we use with the baby. We make realistic expectations. You move a drop, fine, we're excited. You keep on moving, you keep on growing, you keep on going in that direction. So remember to have realistic expectations. Remember the definition of success. I learned something, I have a result, I'm successful. If I keep on walking, I'm going to walk like a baby walks. Every baby learns to walk because we understand the benefit of small steps. Number two, the day controlling you versus you controlling the day. So everybody's familiar with this box, the four quadrants of time. So the bottom two, we're not even going to handle, because the bottom two is not important. So there's two types of not importance, right? There's not important that's urgent. Phone rings in, email hocks in, somebody knocks on your door. Bottom line, it's not important. And then there's not important that's urgent. There's not important that's not urgent, which is basically clips and vachanadishkeit. It's not important and it's not urgent. Those two we're not talking about because everybody understands that those two are not going to get you that's tzlucha. But let's move up to the top two. One is urgent and important. Urgent and important means crisis. You come in, there's already problems you got to deal with. You have to chase crisis. Your day is controlling you. Tzeduva satin. The Asushka Braida was the daf satin, while the Tukta Techam was the daf satin. Then there's not important, not urgent, but important. Meaning to say, Shishrait noch nicht. Those are things, build your business, have a vision for your business. It's the same thing in your marriage. It's the same thing in your personal health. Exercise, working on your marriage, making things better. So it's not urgent, Shishrait nicht, but it's important. If you're going to look at successful people, they spend 90% of their time in not important, but not urgent. They're visionaries. They're royals and noilids. They see what's going to happen. They focus. They plan accordingly. They take care of every problem that could come down the pipe. Mamila, they have a day to focus and live and have energy and grow a business. And 10% of the time, they live in the quadrant one, which is firefighting, crises, having to deal with stuff. Your avoider is to recognize you have to change the shift right now. Whatever your percentage is. If you're spending 25% of your time in crisis and 75% of your time in long-term planning, great. But the chances are that you can make a better shift. You want to move more stuff. And keep things shouldn't fall in there so often. Do things in advance. Control your day. Plan your day. Work things that are going to come down. Put them in your calendar. Don't wait for things to happen. Reach out to customers in advance. Set up a system that they get reached out to. They got reported to. They know what's going on. So you do it in that time. Do it with your family. Proactive. Don't wait till the kid already makes trouble by the table and wants attention of an Einer Strasche, they're leaving the family. Do it in advance. It's much easier. You have Menicha, you have Yishev Hadas. Don't live in crisis. So you want to move the most that you can move from the quadrant of crisis to the quadrant of doing it in advance. Okay? So basically, what you want to do is you want to manage the crises. You want to manage the challenges in your life. But you want to focus and try to focus the most you could on building your business, your future, your health, your vitality, your relationships, your business culture. Focus on there. So, Lamasa, how do you do it? So, let's look at it first from this thing. So, what are we talking about? When we come back to the cycle, you have the machshuva, you want to do well. You get up in the morning, you're gans and driven. You have a good emotion. You're driven. The haltas bamtin, best to get the mood. And you take action, but the right action. Not the action to put out a fire. You take an action to build your business, to be a royas anoilid, to work things in advance, to keep people happy in advance, to give people the skills in advance. You do the right actions, then you get good results. If you get good results, it reinforces the cycle, it keeps on going. So just doing action is not enough. You need to do the right actions. Now, of course, there's crises. We've got to minimize crisis time. We've got to maximize time when we're productive. So here's a great, great example. It's a Kenan Gedenken Day Yusod. Imagine, Eina Falten an Aloch, Falten an Agri, in it, Eina Vaftaman an a Shovel, in it Arbet, in it Arbet with the Shovel, they grouped, and 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 Los op de shovel, gap on de rope, gnam de garoos. Heer ze gaan. Gap a shovel, en ze fielt als ik die hoofd. Ik groep, ze gaat, eet, ze rikt zich, ze gaat, ik die, ik rik, ik mag. It feels good. En het arbeid, en het arbeid, en het arbeid. En jenna zoekt, hello, leger op de shovel. Ik ken het, ik ben busy, ik heb een crisis, ik lijk ze, titzig, ik mis, ik mag, titzig. Hij gaat stuk is er busy. En jenna zoekt hem, ik ga mooi naar het slang de shovel. Nog dan ga ik naar zijn busy, hoe ze gaat doen zijn. Ik ga veel een gewoon shovel in. Ik mis toch zijn busy. Hij is de peegtoe gelegen, maar daar heeft hij in. And he's working and working and working and working. He's got to take the risk for 1 second and drop the shovel. But that's scary. He drops the shovel means that titte schappers. And he's busy. I like the shallows can crisis. And titte schappers is eigenlijk peegen. Titte groenisch. But then if he drops it for 1 second, had de breide, onze gaat hem de rope en jij slaapt hem eruit. It's the same thing. We get into patterns of being busy. But busy action alone is not enough. Ik kan groen van hand tot morgen en ik ga de shallows van de loch. But sometimes you have to drop it and focus on bigger picture. There's a rope. Grab the rope and it takes you out. Kaviyuchel, the mushel is, we have a bashafer also that throws us a rope. Just back off. Do your thing. You don't have... It boils down to the fact the bashafer feed the welt. You got to do your shtadlis, but don't get too caught up with the busyness of the shtadlis being in it and look up and see a lot of times the bashafer gave you a much easier shtadlis if you see the big picture and you see the vision. So get out of focusing crisis and look for opportunity and you'll see a rope that could pull you out and move you to the next level. Number three, what you do want. Many people, everybody that I've coached personally initially when they came in, knew exactly what they don't want. They don't want to be stressed, they don't want to be anxious, they don't want to be poor, they don't want sales to go down, they don't want to have challenges in different areas of their business. But you have to look what you do want. The Moyach is a supercomputer. Chalip Tzuzogin has the Moyach as a taxi driver. the most awesome taxi driver, fancy car, best GPS system, weiß alles, kann dich ziehen überall. The only thing is, if you get into the taxi, and the taxi says, where do you want to go? And you say, not Manhattan. But that's what most people do. Your brain versteht das nicht. Try it with your brain, yeah? Tell your brain, don't think of the color blue. That's all you got. Yeah, blue. The more you start is backwards. You can't say, I don't want to be frustrated. I don't want to be anxious. I don't want to be upset. Was willst du? So I'll show you a mushel when they teach race car drivers how to drive race cars. New driver. So they drive him schnell. He's driving 150 miles an hour. And the trainer at the button, they schlepped it on the button, and the car fleet and starts skidding into a wall. And jeder neue driver tät dasselbe sagt, And they're about to die. And all the trainer does is grabs his head and turns his head. And he drives right out of the skid. The lesson is look where you want to go. Think about it. You all came here, however you came here, you had to cross a bridge. What was the goal when you got on the bridge? To not hit the guardrails. And, right? I don't go. But you understand, and you're smart enough to know, that if you focus on not going to Manhattan, if you focus on not hitting the guardrails, what's going to happen? You're going to smash into the guardrails. So you're all smart enough to know, don't look where you don't want to go. No, but the guardrails, what do you mean? I die. Look where you want to go. It's all going to work out. So you look straight. Why would it be any difference in business? We literally can derail our business by focusing on what we don't want. They have studies in the desert. In the desert, they do a telephone pole, jede mile, 2 mile. People with the goiness that don't want to hit the pole, all the time people hit the poles. Boom, right into the pole. How could you hit the pole? It's not possible. Because that's how it works. Where you look is where you go. You don't want to hit the guardrail, you hit the guardrail. Enough. Where do you want to go? What do you want? Get up in the morning and focus what I want. I want to feel awesome today. I want to be matzliach today. I want to have an awesome company. I want the culture to knock. I want to come home tonight and be so excited how my day went. I want to come home tonight and be excited to see my kids. I want to be excited to go learn and have the energy in Brem. As they steam, as Volkan was developed, the brain got to steam for dich. Die weiß, wie sie touch the news? Nein. The daft service? Nein. Guest instruction, touch my news. Did the job. High both my fees. Die weiß, wie sie matitis? M42. L27, nobody knows. You don't have to know how to be successful either. Your brain knows. Tell it what you want. The Bashefa gave you a supercomputer. Just give instructions. It's the ultimate taxi driver. Zugen was du willst ja. Wieso was du fielen mit der Steistof? Wieso was du fielen mit der Geistschlofen? Wieso was du fielen mit dem Tug? What's that sloche you want to have? Just give it. Jeder hat erweist, metraget, sanget. It's science. You did it when you drove here. Why wouldn't you do it in your life? You would never think of looking at the guardrail. Why would you look in the guardrail in your marriage? Why would you look in the guardrail in your life? Look straight, and you'll go straight. How does that apply? That's machshuva. So if you think straight, your machshuva is good, you're going to have good thoughts, because you'll be in that mindset when you look straight, when you drove here. That's going to make that you take the right action, the fu is grut, it's going to give you the result, and mamayla, it's going to reinforce the thought, and yatzlucha won't break, and continue going. Next. What you could control. What you can control. So it's important to know that there are many things in life you cannot control. What's outside your control? Other people's actions, other people's opinions, other people's feelings, other people's mistakes, nisyonos, adversity. What could you control? Your attitude, your effort, your behavior, your actions. If you do anything else, the Groys Chochem, and Jeff Bezos says when he comes into his office and he's stressed out because there are a million things going on in his life, he says, what can I focus on? He sends out his next email. He makes a phone call. And all of a sudden, he feels ruhig again. Because he realizes he could have a big company, but there's most of the things he cannot control. If you focus on what you control, hishtadlis, don't be worried about Yenis hishtadlis. Be worried about your hishtadlis. Focus on what you could control. You're going to feel a sense of empowerment and control in your day. What do you want? You want to feel a sense of control. You want to feel on top of your game. You want to be what's called in a flow state, in a coherent state. It feels good. You could do your best to fleece a guide. How does it work? When you feel a sense of control. When you don't feel a sense of control, you have anxiety, you have fear, you have panic, you have stress. You're not in a good situation. When you feel a sense of control, it's a guide. Here's a good mushul to bring it out to you. Imagine the fustahaim, fanachasana, mansi, Zwei Seigel zu früh in der Fuß. And for this Mushel, let's imagine everybody you love is in the car, or minivan, or truck, whatever, bus. And everybody, family, children, Einikluch, Shveya, Shvige, everybody's, you bring everybody home from the Chasana. And you're driving in Mitamul, you notice everybody's ruhig, everybody's geschmack, everybody's in a good mood. You're driving, or im Schluft a bissl music in the background. And there's these zwei headlights came the Kegeneba. Let's think about for a minute. Who's coming? The Chasana was there, so the guy's not going back to the Chasana, that's for sure. So who's driving 2 a.m.? Kid that stole his father's car, somebody that's coming back from the bar, somebody that has no life. Not exactly the person who you want to be basically driving what represents a loaded machine gun across your family. So your family's driving you're in your family, you're driving very ruhig, and a loaded machine gun is coming. You have no idea who's holding the gun. The chances are that it's not somebody you want to be holding the gun, coming right across your family, and the only block between you and a loaded machine gun against everybody you love is two yellow lines. And you're calm. Shemi Shemaim. How can you be calm? In Eitz Shul, we walk around like this. Yeah, you have it coming right across your car, 2 a.m, a loaded machine gun, two yellow lines. How could you be calm? It makes no sense. Shemi Shemaim. The answer is, you're focusing on your steering wheel. And you have full control of your steering wheel. And you feel confident. You feel ruhig. If you start focusing on his steering wheel, you're going to be in bad trouble. You're going to panic. You're going to be scared. When you come into your office in the morning, focus on your steering wheel. What could you do? What could you change? What could you make it happen? And then you feel a sense of control. So what could you control, Lamasa? Only two things. Your machshuva and your dibur hamaaseh. That's it. Now let's take it back to the success cycle. You control your machshuva and you control your maaseh. Why is that everything you need to control? Because if you control your machshuva, it's going to give you good emotion. If you have strong emotion, you'll do a good maaseh. You do a good maaseh, you're going to get a result. You get a result that reinforces your thought, and segayit, and segayit, and segayit, and segayit. If you focus on what you cannot control, you're not going to get a result, because it's gunish getin. As we beat the end team, Mr. Shungen came in and ergets. As long as you focus on your machshava and your control, your actions, you're going to be able to control your life and continue making the cycle go and having atzlocha. Finally, making two big commitments. Science shows that consistent small actions, the boring way to succeed, is really the only way to succeed. Because the brain does not allow change. You know, we're now very familiar, unfortunately, with the Iron Dome system. If something comes in, it shoots it down. We have an eternal Iron Dome system. The reason why we get up in the morning and we stay in the same family, same kehillah, same wife, same program, is there's an Iron Dome system. You want to change the system, it gets shot down. We get comfortable. We have a safety mechanism that doesn't let us grow, doesn't let us get out of the system. As soon as we try to change it, we feel uncomfortable. We feel resistance. An Iron Dome system comes to keep us safe and happy. But if you take small results, you get by the system because you're not shaking it. Kleiner results. So I urge you, everybody here today, you were here today, you spent money. More importantly, you spent time. An enormous amount of time here. You listened. If you go home with information, you wasted your day because you could have got all this information for $12 in about 100 different books in Barnes & Nobles. If you came here, you didn't come here for information. You came here for transformation. And if you have even a little bit of a transformation, then you underpaid 10 times. Because what you can get is invaluable. You walk out of here with a little transformation, your life will never be the same. So I urge you to take me on to this challenge. Let's focus on the next 52 weeks. 1 year. But nothing big. You commit for the next 52 weeks, you're going to make a teeny change every week. But you're going to do it now. You're going to make a commitment now. I don't care what area of your life, because atzlocha brings atzlocha. If you grow a circle, the whole circle grows. So it doesn't matter to me what it is. It could be in your marriage. It could be in your business. It could be with your children. I don't care. because Hatzlucha in any area will bring Hatzlucha to other areas of your life. Preferably business, because that's what you're here for today. Make a commitment. One shift for the next 7 days. One shift. 6 days. Sheshimai Masa. One thing, but you have to do it no matter what for 7 days. For 6 days. So in other words, it doesn't matter what the commitment was. If you committed to it, making one full day, getting up earlier, going to sleep earlier, doing exercise, doing a mind, you know, the exercise that he spoke about this morning, writing everything down to clarify my mind, spending 10 minutes in meditation, learning Chovos Avos, whatever it is. You heard loads of examples today of what successful people do. One thing, Kiknish, Shadab, one thing that you're going to do. I'm asking you for one thing for the next 6 days. That's it. If you do this, you'll get started with a system. It's going to be gring. It's going to be nothing. It's going to be a tiny thing. You'll look over. You'll go through the cycle in a week from now. So what you're going to basically do is you're going to pick something. And it's going to be b'machshuva now. Okay? Hopefully, you're going to be motivated and say, I spent so much time in that day. I want it to work. And you're going to do the action. And you're going to get a result. One or two things are going to happen. You're either going to learn something and say, okay, I'm not doing this next week, but I'm going to tweak it because now I know something. Or you're going to get a result. And it's going to reinforce your thoughts. And that will be done. You know why? How many times did it take for you to eat ice cream to know that you like ice cream? Once. If it works, it's in. It got under the radar. But not something big. Something small. If it's a kleine Sach, it's under the radar, it's in. Because you had benefit. If you didn't have benefit, learn something from it and redo something else. So let's go back to the basic. What you're going to do is you're going to apply the ultimate success formula for 52 weeks. If you do it, I look forward to meeting you at the next one of these events and you telling me the story of the enormous success you had this year. I'm telling you, I did this with teams of groups in 2020. There's nobody that I work with this system that didn't earn $200,000, and many earned over $1 million. And they were successful people. They didn't have the success before. Ich habe gunisch geteamt für sei. Sei sam gejuchelt. Ich habe rausgebringt sehr geschreunis und sehr keuches. By getting them caught up in this idea. Which means, number one, decide a little action you're going to do. I'm not going to stop talking until everybody picks up their hand and says that they have one. You're going to take the action for 6 days. You're going to notice whether it's working or not. If it works, it's going to continue. And you're going to see like a nachheins. If it's not going to work, recognize you learned something. That's not a good idea. Change the idea. Do it again. Is anybody in first for 1 week to make a commitment today and do it for 1 week? I'm not doing it. I want you to use it. I have been by so many of these events. The Olam Gaitaros, and the second you get to your car, it's game over. And you feel good because you went to an event. Es gunish hoben fun es. Es sich machen vielen getant nach. And the money goes the ibit. Go out today and you're ready here. It's a shoot. Bishan do anyways. If it likes the Sharan and a chayfetz lamasa, unfortunately, put it this way. If you put it in lamasa, you're going to be zoiche to unbelievable atzlocha. There's enormous amount of energy here. It's very simple. Don't walk out. There's so much information you got. It's going to be there with you. Everything you heard was helpful. But tachlis. If you walk out of here with something practical, one thing you're doing for the next 6 days, that's it. One little nekidah, one positive thing you're doing for the next 6 days, you won't believe it. You'll see it in a week. You'll see it work for you. Why wouldn't you continue doing it for the next 52 weeks? If you do it for 52 weeks, I have seen it happen. Your income will go up exponentially. Your government, your whatever you do, an organization, your business will grow exponentially. You won't even believe it. And the reason why nobody succeeds is because they don't get the cycle going. They want big things, big fixes. It doesn't work. Successful people do small things. And that's how they succeed. That's their secret. But consistent. Piskeli Pesach Shamachat. Vani Eftach Loke Pesach Pesach Shalilam. Aber geht von Marebbe, der Duvet Bakens, Kroen, der Vruch, wenn ich bin in der Buch in Yeshiva und Tels. Aber der Pesach Shamachat darf sein Dorch in Dorch. It has to be Mephilish. What's the Pesach Shamachat? You want to have a Pesach Shalom? Everybody came in, they want a Pesach Shalom. You have an enormous amount of goals. Gewaldig. If you don't walk out of here with a Pesach Shamachat, today, because that's the recipe, Gemurot is gesucht. Pischa the Pesach Shamachat. What is the Pesach Shamachat? And you have to do it dorch and dorch. 6 days. And the Bashefa promises you back at the Chof Machat Pesach Shalom. And I look forward from every one of you to hear me at Hashem. Ibarayu gezintahait. the Boar Summit in Yerushalayim, Yir HaKodesh, to hear your success stories. There's no question in my mind they're going to come. I look forward to seeing and celebrating with every one of you at the top of what you could be.